Okay, so in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to create a cash flow forecast in Excel. So in terms of the math, it's no different to when you do it in hand. So this video will just focus on showing how we actually do all the formulas. So firstly, down here, we got total receipts. So in this cell here, what we want to do is we want to add up all of the white cells. Same thing in this cell here, we want to add up all of the white cells here, so on and so forth, all the way across. Here, we want to add up in this cell every single item in from January to December. So for example, we might have sales in here. So we want to add up every single month the sales. Here, we want to add up every single month for this particular item, so on all the way down. And so this is how you're doing. There's lots of different ways you can actually going about doing this. What we have to do is we have to create a sum formula. And this is, I think, is the easiest, but you may know of other ways that you think is easy yourself. So we put the cursor where we want to do the calculations. We left click, so we can see that we now outline the cell we want to do the formula in. We simply click auto sum. Left click, hold the button down on the first cell, so that's the first white cell. I'm holding the left click button down and I'm just sort of dragging it down to the last cell that I want to include. So what we're telling Excel is that we want to sum up or add up every single cell within this formula here. And all I need to do now is to click enter. And what we can then see is if we add some bits to it, it now all adds up. If I want to delete it again, highlight it and click the delete button on the keyboard. Now this done this calculation, I could do the same thing again. So choose the cell you want to add it up to, click auto sum, left click on the first cell you want to include, hold the button down and just drag all the way down to the bottom, only to include the last white cell and click enter. And again, it's going to add up if we add stuff to it. However, there is a much easier way to go about this. So I'm clicking delete just to get rid of them. Because once I've already done the formula in here, I can copy the formula all the way across. And I do so by clicking in the cell where I've already done a calculation. We can see down here, there is a square down in the bottom corner. And when we hover over it, the mouse changes to this black cross. So when it's a black cross like this, left click and hold the button down. So I'm holding the left mouse button down now and just drag it all the way to the very last cell. And there, it's added it all up. The same thing over here. So here I want to add up everything in here. So first I left click in the cell I want to do the formula. I click auto sum. I left click and I move to the side. Right all the way over here, and once I've included January to December, I simply click enter and I can now drag this down like I did before. So down in the right hand corner, make the mouse button or cursor turn black, left click, hold the button, drag the button down. And now I've done all the income section, I can now do the payment section. The payment section works exactly the same way. So here, I want to add up everything here. And the same thing for all of these. Here, I want to add up everything up here. So, put your left click in the cell you want to add everything up in. Click auto sum. Left click in the first cell. Drag it all the way down to the last cell. Only to include the white cells. Click enter. Drag it across. Just like that. And the same thing up here. Click on the cell, auto sum, left click, drag it all the way across, enter. And left click, drag it all the way down to here. So now these two have added up. I could add a few numbers just to double check that it actually does add up. And it clearly does. And now delete all of them. Now we only got left to do the opening, the bank balance section down here. Firstly, the opening bank balance, we're going to assume it's zero. So I just put in zero. Add receipts. So if you recall the add receipts section, what we're taking, what we're saying is we just want this cell here to be equal to our total receipts up here. So first of all, let's just put in a number so we got something to go by. Let's say it's that amount here. So the add receipts should be equal to, so now I'm on the keyboard, I'm clicking on the equal to sign. This basically tells Excel I want to do a formula, but actually all I want to do is I want to say that this cell is equal to, and I left click on the cell I want it to be equal to, and enter. And then it automatically comes down. And the clever thing about it, if I added something else, we can see this has changed. It now changes down here as well. The less payments bit, exactly the same principle. Here we are including the total payments for January. We can see we've got January up here. So all we're saying is that this cell should be equal to the total payments for January. So click on the keyboard key equal to, left click on total payments, and click enter on the keyboard. So if we add a couple of numbers here, we can see that it also adds up here. And then finally, we want to calculate the closing bank balance for the month of January. And just to recap on the formula, it's the opening bank balance, add the receipts, less the payments, or take away the payments, and that gives us our bank balance in the end of the period. So equal to this one plus this one minus our payments. That gives us our closing bank balance. So we have got in the end of the month £4,080 in our bank balance. So the next month, and if you recall doing this in hand, this cell here is the opening bank balance of February. And the opening bank balance of February is the same as our closing bank balance of January. So again, here we can just go equal to, so on the keyboard, left click on the closing bank balance, click enter. That's it. So to make life nice and simple, put it, click on the opening bank balance of this month. Go down to the corner so the icon turns black. Left click, hold the button down, drag it all the way across. And the same thing with, so highlight, so I'm left clicking in the first cell, I'm holding the button down, the left click button, and I choose all the three other items. Go down here in the bottom so it turns black. Left click, scroll it across. Now, if we add some numbers all over the place, you can see they all get included where they need to be. So all of the calculations are done for you. And if you delete them again, they go away. Now, so that's effectively how you create a cash flow forecast in Excel. The only last thing to sort of note is a couple of things that's worth knowing in Excel. So let's pretend that our sales for January to December is the same amount every month. Let's pretend it's £1,000. An easy way to actually put it in, instead of physically writing £1,000 in each of these formulas, is to put in £1,000 over here. And again, I can do the same thing where I might take the bottom corner, left click, and drag it all the way across, and then copies the formula all the way across. So that's pretty useful and a good time saver. Now, let's imagine another scenario. Let's imagine that I'm buying a sofa, and that sofa cost me £5,000. Let's imagine I buy it in April for £5,000. All I would do is I would put in £5,000, and that would be, that's £5,000here. So that's fairly straightforward. How about, though, if I couldn't afford this sofa for £5,000? How about it was just too expensive for me? So what I had to do is I had to split this £5,000 off in down payments for every month during this year. So I pay off the £5,000 starting in January, ending in December, so in 12 installments. So I paid off every month. How would I do that? Well, most people have got a propensity to, or they're thinking, well, I'm just going to do it on the calculator, that's the quickest. But actually, there's a much quicker and better way of doing that. And that is simply by going into, so I'm taking the first cell here, I want to do a calculation. So I want to work out what 12 parts of 5,000. So what is 5,000 divided by 12? So instead of doing it on the calculator, I can use Excel as a calculator. And I simply do that by starting by saying equal to. So if I write in 5,000 pounds and then divide it by and 12, Excel calculates it for me. And what I can do now is, again, I can take it and I can simply drag it all the way across. And what we can see is that the 417 pounds adds up to 5,000 pounds. One last thing to note here is that actually 5,000 divided by 12 is not 417. If we take a cell here and I click up on this number up here, what happens is Excel shows you all of the decimal points that it actually is. So in fact, 5,000 divided by 12 is 416.667. But because most people don't like looking at these decimal points, what Excel automatically does is it just formats it to show it without decimal points. So it's kind of actually doesn't round, but it just shows you the number rounded without the decimal points. But within each cell, so if we're going to click on this, we can see that it actually says 416.667. So if I want to put it away again, so I'll just click on this other one here. That's it. That's all there is to know about creating formulas, doing a cash flow forecast in Excel.